Hello everyone, I hope you will be fit and fine. Previous topic we have covered with the MySQL commands, MySQL functions, functions related to aggregate functions and numeric functions, and single line and multi-line functions, and join. So we have covered all the functions in a MySQL. So I am repeating again, full syllabus I am revising here. And you need to practice at home so that this topic will be completely revision. So first introduction. Starting with the database, what is database? It is a relational database, simply a database that store a related to information. What is database? You have created a database. Simply whatever you are creating are tables, views, synonyms, all are stored in a database. So across the multiple table and allow you to query information and more than one table at the time. You can create more than one table at a time. You can store in a database. So database, MySQL is a relational database. SQL is a relational database. You learn about the various type of databases, relational databases. Here, advantages of databases. What is database? What are the advantages of database here? It reduces data redundancy, means repeated data not allowed in this. And controlling data inconsistency, you can control your data. Enforcing standard, you can enforce to view the records, you can enforce. And data secure, you can secure your data by giving the grant and revoke TCL commands. So here some disadvantages also. So disadvantages of database are database complexity. Some have a database complexities in there, and hardware and software startup cost. Whenever you want to start up for a hardware and software for a SQL, not a for MySQL. MySQL it is a takes a small space and it is a free of cost in the market. For SQL, you need a cost of hardware and software both, and damage to database affects virtually all the application program. Damage, sometimes it damage also, and extensive conversion cost. Whenever you want to extensive conversion, then it may takes a cost. Initial training required. Whenever you want to use it, course, before using it, you need to initial training for this for using. Some data models are also there. What is data model? Data models define how the logical structure of database is a modeled, or data models are fundamental entities. What are data models? These are a fundamental entities to introduce abstraction in a DBMS. Data models define the how data is connected to each other and how they are processed and stored inside the system. So types of data models are, first, relational data model, second, network data models, and third, hierarchical data model. Otherwise there are 4 or 5 data models are only basic requirement of your in your syllabus, that is a relational data model. So we'll quick revise all the topics here. So relational data models, in a the relational model, all data must be stored in a relational table. And second, each relation consists of row and column. Row and column. Records are in a row and column. Relation must have a header and body. So body, header and body to be related from a more than one table. The header is just simply the list of the columns in the relation, header part, which have a list of columns which you are creating, and body part, that which value you are storing in that. So the body is the set of the data that actually populates the relational organized into a rows. So relational softwares are in the market. There is a Oracle, Postgres. It costs, you need to take a license for it. Oracle and some this Progress softwares and Prima database management, RDM server. All these are a MySQL. This is a free. Some software here, these are a free. And see, relational data model terminology here I have defined as a, first it is a relation. First it is a relation. Second, tuple. Relation means more than one table can be relate here. Tuples means record, row information, one type of value, one type of record, one person record, one employee record, one product record, that is called tuple. Attribute means one type of value. See, your admission number, one type of value. Name is a one type of value. See, one type of value which is a attribute filled column. So entity which is exist, just like a school is a exist. School is a entity. Under school, teachers, students and all employees in that. So these are called attribute. And degree column in a relation is called degree. Cardinality means record in a relation. Cardinality means record, row in a relation. Tuple in a relation is called cardinality. Degree means attribute in a relation, column in a relation, field in a relation, that is called degree. Now relation. What is relation? Relation is a something used to refer to the table in relational database, but is more commonly used to describe the relationship that can be created between the those tables. In the relation, relational database, see something related which I am giving example of two table, your student table and marks table. So there, these tables columns are in a relation. So this is called relation, something used to refer to tables in a relational database, but more commonly used to describe the relationship that can be created between the those table. Next, tuple. What is tuple? That is a row, record and complete information. So a table has a row and columns, where row represent the record, where row represent the record and column represent the attribute. And tuple, what is tuple here? Tuple is a single row. What is tuple? Single row record, one type of value of a table which consists of single record for a for the relation is called a tuple. Relation instance or in finite set of the tuples in the relation database system represent the relation instance. So one type of value is displaying complete information about the anything. So that is called tuple, row and record. So attribute means one type of value. See, one, I am giving an admission number. So one type of value, name is a one type of value, class is a one type of value. See, one type of value is called attribute, field and column. So entity here, an entity is a real world object. What is an entity? It is a real world object that are represented in a database. It can be any object. It can be any object, place, person or class, anything. Which we are making a, we are creating a table which is a exist, just person. If I am making a record about a person, all detail or the properties of that person I am making. So person is a entity here, all attributes related to roll number, name, class, date of birth, father name, mother name, house address, telephone number, all related to its property, that is called attribute. So here person is a entity. So store in DBMS, we store data in the form of table containing information about the entity type, like a students, teachers, employee, etc. So here degree. What is degree? The degree of a relationship, also known as a cardinality. It is a number of occurrence in a one entity which are associated to number of occurrence in a another. So degree means column which are linked together. See, I am talking about the student record. Admission number, one type of value. Name of the student, that is a one type of value. Class, marks, date of birth, father name, mother name, subject, anything. These are individual value which are combined together, that is called degree. So here cardinality. Cardinality means it is also called the degree of relation. Cardinality, column in a relation which makes a record. So cardinality, record in a relation. So a row of a one table and row of another table. I am talking about student table and marks table. So record all the rows from a student table and all the rows from a marks table which are in a relation, that is called cardinality. So cardinality can be, the relation can be make one to one. One student have a one. So one to many, one teacher teaching a many students. So many to many means that is a many teachers teaching a many students. You can give an example of that with the cardinality. This is a relationship between the cardinality. So here we'll talk about the keys. What is keys? Keys is a one type of value, attribute, one type of data which we are storing in a table. So here key, a key is a field or combination of fields in a database table used to retrieve and sort rows in the table based on the certain requirement. And keys are defined to the speed of access data. Speed of, speedily you can access your data from a table, and many cases to create a link between the different tables. See, you have created a so many table. Just I have talked about the student table and marks table. So as you can create so many tables and you can link together with the help of keys. So type of keys, we'll discuss about type of keys here. First, super key. This is like a primary key, but it is a super key. Primary key, candidate key, alternate key, foreign key, compound key, composite key, and surrogate key. These all are keys which are used in a SQL, but their compound, composite, surrogate, and super keys are not in a syllabus, but I am just giving a small demo to you. So super key, what is super key? See here, a super key is a group of single or multiple keys. It is a single key and multiple keys which identify row in a table. Super key may have a additional attribute that are not needed for a unique identification. Already it become a unique. Just you can give a phone number. Each and every person have a different phone number. You can give the example of super key, that is a phone number. So primary key, that you know, we have already so many times discussed about the primary key, or column or a group of column in a table which help us to uniquely identify every row that tables is called a primary key. In a every table, first you need to create a primary key. With the help of primary key, you can set relation more than one table. Just I have discussed about the student and marks table. See, student have a admission number. Your admission number, that is become a primary key. In a marks table, there is also primary key as a admission number with the help of first key to second key. Second key in a marks table, which value will be derived from a primary key of a student table. So these are according to in a link. So it is a uniquely identified in a table. Next, candidate key. So what is candidate key? It just like a primary key, it can become a primary key. In any absence of primary key, you can make a candidate key as a primary key. A super key with the no repeated attribute is called candidate key. No repeated attribute. It should be no repeated value in a candidate key. The primary key should be selected from a candidate key. Every table must have at least single candidate key. See here, example I have written, student ID, roll number, ID, roll number. Roll number should be unique. So this become a primary key and this become a candidate key. The roll number in this table is a candidate key. So roll number, each and every student have a different roll number. So unique identity column you can make as a candidate key. So now alternate key. So all the keys which are not primary key are called alternate key. See, you have created a primary key as an admission number. So other name, class, marks, date of birth, father name, mother name, all keys, other keys, which is not a primary key, other keys are called alternate key. So all the keys which are not a primary key are called alternate key. It is a candidate key which is currently not in primary key. However, table may have a single or multiple choice of a primary key. So here example, see, this is a primary key, 1, 2, student ID, roll number become a candidate key, name, other keys, which is a this father first name, last name, and email also can be become a candidate key. So other key which is not a primary key and candidate other keys is called alternate key. See the relation, this primary key and this second table, roll number and email can be as a candidate key because it has a unique value. Other keys now it is a alternate key. So now foreign key. Foreign key means foreign key can be created more than one in a table. Remember one thing, primary key we can create only one in a table, but foreign key can be created more than one in a table, but its value derived from a parent tables of a primary key. See here, foreign key is a column which is added to create a relationship with the other table. Foreign key help us to maintain a data integrity and so always allow to navigation between the two different instance of the entity. Every relationship in the model needs to support by the foreign key. Without foreign key, we can't set relation in the table. See the example here, one is a department table and another is a teacher table, and so here department code in this table did become a primary key and department name. Here teacher ID is a primary key and first name, last name is here. Now this link to the this will be become a, this is a foreign key and this is a primary key, and both can be linked together with the help of foreign key. So in example, we have two table, each department in a school. However, there is a no way to see which search work in which department. In this table, adding a foreign key in the department code. So department code you need to add as a primary foreign key, and the teacher name and can be created as a relationship between the two table. So both have a similar value. So we can make a relationship with the similar value. See your teacher ID, department, first name and last name. So we can make relationship between the two table here. Difference between both. So primary key help you uniquely identify records in a table. And here it is a foreign key, it is a field in the table that is a primary key of another table, second table. Just I have talked about the marks table, which is an admission number, that is a primary key. But when we are joining together with the first table to second table, that become a foreign key. And primary key never accept the null value. You must input value in primary key. Foreign key can accept a empty value, or foreign key can be created more than one. Primary can create only one. So now we'll discuss about the, this is not in your syllabus, but little demo I am giving you. So compound key has a many field which allow you to uniquely recognize specific record. It is a possible that each column may be not unique by itself. So within the database, however, when you combine with the other columns or a columns, the combination of composite key become a unique. So see here, order number, product ID and this. So here product order, this is a primary key, and product ID cannot be as a primary key because everybody order it. So this become a order number, that is a primary key. This can become a compound key, just like a composite key. Composite key, a key which has a multiple attributes to a uniquely identify in a rows in a table is called composite key. The difference between composite and the compound and composite key is that any part of the compound key can be foreign key. Any part of the compound key can become a foreign key, but composite key may or may not be part of the foreign key. Now we'll discuss about the surrogate key. What is surrogate key? An artificial key. It is an artificial key which aim to uniquely identify. See, the word surrogate, identify each record is called surrogate key. These kind of keys are unique, but they are created when you don't have any natural primary key. You haven't created any primary key or a composite key, then you can use as a surrogate key here. They do not lead any meaning on the data, and surrogate key is a usually can be used in a integer only. So this is not part of your syllabus. See here, F name, L name, first name, last name is here. Now, so there is no requirement of primary key here, just like a admission number, any employee number, any, no need require of that. In that case, start time or end time, that become a surrogate key. So now, quick revision of referential integrity. What is it? The data in a table that is not linked either probably in the value or to other table. To maintain a referential integrity, data that is a link across the table. You can link data across the table. So referential integrity, RI, is the relational database concept, which states that table relationship must always be in a constant. In other words, any foreign key field must agree with the primary key that is a reference by the foreign key. See, if you are using two keys, two tables value, and first is a primary parent table, second is a child table, just like a student and marks. So from first table and second table, you are referring with the admission number to the second table. So you need to use reference and integrity as a foreign key. Reference and integrity, just like a reference from student admission number. So this integrity matching field from a primary key table, the table key, and related to field have the same data types. Both the tables belong to the same database. Both tables should be belong to the same table. Otherwise, it will not make a relationship between the two tables. So here you can set reference and integrity with the following condition. First, the matching fields from the primary table is the primary key, and the second, the related to field have the same data types. Both the tables should have a same data types, and both the tables belong to the same database. So these points you have to remember for a reference and integrity. Here, after enforcing reference and integrity, you can observe the following. You need to follow the rules here. Not possible to enter a value in foreign key. Remember one thing, its value automatically derived from a parent table, student table. Which table you are using from a main base table. So its value automatically derived from a base table, and you can't alter it. You can modify the value in it. Field of the related table and doesn't exist in the primary key of a primary table. So another thing, you can't delete a record from a primary table. You can't delete a record from a primary table if matching record exists in the related to table. If matching from a first table to second table, base table to another table, derived table, so that value should be matched and record should be exist there. So here you can't change the primary key value. Remember one thing, once you have inputted a value in primary key, you can't change it. And primary table, if the record has related to record, if it is matching to the another table record, so you can't alter it, you can modify it any value. So here some points we'll discuss about the MySQL also. It is same as a SQL or MySQL. MySQL is a world most popular open source relational database. It is a free of cost. You can download it and you can alter, you can modify and redistribute. MySQL is a cross platform, just like a Python. It is a cross platform, which means runs on a number of different platforms. Any platform you can run it, and as a Windows, Linux and Mac operating system. Even your mobile phone also you can run your MySQL. So MySQL is a written in a C and C++. It is a written in a C and C++ programming language, and it is related to under the name of the co-founder Michael Windows. So here we'll discuss about the MySQL server and client. What is server? What is client here? The MySQL server is a package we'll install in a MySQL database server, which you can interact with the using a MySQL client. See, what is client? Client and server and client. So you can use as a server, as a client, you can use MySQL client to send the commands to any SQL server. See, client means I'm using MySQL and in my laptop, my PC. So whatever I am giving or sending a commands from my system, so that is called client side command, and which request is going to the MySQL database, that is the server. So SQL stand for the structured query language. It designed for managing data in the relational database management system. So here it is pronounced as a SQL, not a SQL, SQL, or a sometimes SQL is a database language. It is used to database creation, deletion, fetching rows, and the modifying a record, etc. The same work which done in a MySQL, and same work in a SQL also. So here SQL statement are DDL. These are the classic categorize of the statement of the SQL or MySQL. Data definition language, DDL commands. In this, we can create a table, we can alter a table, we can delete a table, we can drop a column. So this is a part of DDL. And DML means data manipulation language, which in this you can manipulate with the existing value. You can insert a value, you can delete a records, you can update a records. So commit and rollback, that is part of the DML. And another is a TCL or DCL, data control language. In this you can write grant and revoke. So that is a part of DCL. And transaction control language, TCL, it is part of, you can make update your tables with the transaction, set transaction, start transaction, commit, rollback, and save point. There are so many topics will be covered in this. So here DDL commands, what are the part of this? You can create a table, you can drop a table, you can alter a table, you can truncate a table, commit, rename. So these are part of DDL. And DML, you can select a record. Whatever you have already inserted a record, that can be viewed with the select command. Insert, you can insert a record, input a record, update, whatever existing value you have put it wrong, that can be updated. And delete, any record which is a unwanted record can be removed. And merge, record can be merged, call record can be call once, delete. So DCL command, that is a grant and revoke. Grant means giving a permission. Revoke means removing a permission. It is a part of DCL. So TCL, transaction control language, here commit, rollback, save point are part of the set transaction, start transaction. It is a part of TCL, which is related to update value. So see here, this is a summary of all these. And DDL, you can create a table, alter table, drop table, truncate table. See, alter have some parts. By using alter, you can add a column, you can modify a column, you can drop a column, you can change a column, you can rename a column. And drop can be remove a table structure. And if we are applying with the alter, that drop the column also. Truncate will remove the structure of table, truncated the value, commit, complete, rename, table can be renamed. And DML all select, insert, update, delete, merge, call, explain, plan, lock table. You can lock a table in a DML. Grant, revoke is a part of DCL. and TCL commit rollback save point and set transaction start transaction. These are a part of TCL. Now we'll discuss about the data types. Here data types, we have already discussed about the char or varchar. Char is a fixed length. Once you have defined a length of in a char data type, that will be fixed for each and every value. See, what is the example of this char? If I have defined a name as a column, so I have fixed the value 20, but there is a name in a, I am putting a one single character or two character, MR, MS. So only two characters are required for that, but it will consume a 20 bytes in a each and every record. So in a varchar, what is the difference between both varchar? Varchar, it takes a variable length. If I have declared a column name as a name, I have declared a varchar data type with the 20 limit. But see, I am putting in that RAM RAM. How many characters in this? 3 characters. But what does it? It will consume only 3 bytes in that column, and other 17 bytes will be released by the varchar. It will give free by the 17 bytes. Otherwise, char, what does char? It takes a 20 bytes in a each and every record. So this is another for text format. Maximum it's limited to 255 characters here, but mostly use char or varchar you have to use. And text for text purpose, this is also mid text, medium text, long text also. These can be used in a SQL or MySQL. And text, single length, median, long text, these all can be used. So there another data type is a float. This is for decimal points. You can put a decimal value in this. It takes a 4 bytes. Character consume the limit as a how many, 20 I have written, 20 bytes will be consumed. In this 4 bytes is a required in a hard disk. So time is also data type. It takes a 3 bytes. Enum is there, 1 to 2 bytes it consumes. Set is also, it takes a according to bytes. Dates require 3 bytes. 3 bytes mean DDMMYY. So 3 bytes it consume for a YYYY. This is for 1 byte, year, month or date. And date and time it takes a 8 bytes. How? This is for YYY, MMHH. YY for year, MM for month, DD for date, and HH for hours, MM for minutes, SS for second. It takes a 8 bytes. Timestamp, this is a 4 byte. This is not a not in your syllabus. So difference between this already I have discussed is it a full name of the characters. It full name as a variable character. It is store the value fixed length and are padded with the space and characters to match the specified length. And here varchar store the value variable length, maximum 1 byte or a 2 bytes length prefix as a not padded with the any character. And it can hold maximum 255 characters and it can hold maximum 65,535 characters in a varchar. So it uses static memories. Static memory means fixed value. Fixed memory will be consumed. If you have declared a data type as a char, I have declared name as a char data type, which I have declared as a 20. So automatically it will consume a 20 byte each and every record. So here allocation of MySQL create a table emp name char 20 is given here. So name have a 20 bytes. So here it will affect the 20 bytes for each and every character. So here allocation create a name 20. It will release the other whatever you are inserting a value in varchar, other bytes will be released by the varchar. So create database, that you know, create database, database name, and it is a creating a database, and use for using use database name, that you know, create table, that is a create and table, both are a keyword, table name may be any, and according to data pipe you have to, you are aware about this, you can create a table, that I am not taking much time for you. See here, creating a table with the primary key. So how to create a primary key? Create table person. Person is a table. Person ID int unsigned not null primary key. This constraint you can apply with this. And last name, first name, address, city. Any columns you can create with the separated with the comma. And here, see how you can set a primary key. Primary key, person ID. Person ID, this ID become a primary key of a, this. See here. Foreign key, how to create a foreign key? Create table accounts, account ID. This is a columns. And foreign key, person ID from previous table, and reference person, person ID. This become a foreign key. Person table, and here account ID, that is a matching with the both the tables. So here, unique, how to use unique constraint. You have to write a unique key, constraint here. To each and every record will be accepted by unique value. So you can use unique constraint here. And default. See here, default value also, while creating a table, at same time you can put a default value. So create table student, roll number int not null primary key, student name char 50 and not null, and default already value is given in this student name Sani. So marks decimal, any class. If you are creating your student table, the class column you can put as a default value 12. So each and every record, it automatically comes in a class column as a 12. Check constraint also you can apply. Marks, it will check. Check constraint is apply here. Check marks greater than 0. So everybody, marks should be greater than 0. It will accept, otherwise it will not accept. While creating a table, you need to create a check constraint. Primary, that you know how to use a primary key. So update command with the DML. So how to update? Update table name. Table name, this is a table name. Set column name equal new value, where ID equal this. So this value will be updated with the new value. And deleting a record, how to delete a record? Delete from table name. So directly you have to write to delete from table name, where ID equal 8, where roll number equal any. So that record will be removed. So alter command is also there. It is a DDL, part of DDL. Create table with the alter, modify, rename, that you can do. You have already done in a practical. Modifying, adding a value, change also. column, if any column you have created wrongly, you want to change that name, you can change alter table, table name, change address, change address. This is a new, which is a address previous one. So this value will be changed. See, from existing table you can create a new table. Create table. This is a new table name. As select as is a keyword, as select star, all the value will be selected from this table and will be created in this table. This is a new table. So again and again, same existing table values can be created with the new table. And drop, that you know what is the use of drop, to remove permanently from a database. Drop table, table name. See here, drop table, user table 2019, it will be removed from here. To select, to view or record, if there is any question, to view, to show, to select, display, anything written in that, only you have to use a select keyword. Select will view all the record from a SQL or MySQL. Asterisk means all record will be selected from a my table. This is a table name which you want to display here. And select particular column can be selected. Multiple column can be selected with the condition, by using where clause, select star from my table where username equal my user. So particular column can be created. Distinct, this is a very important. Distinct will display only original value, repeated value will be eliminated in a distinct. The distinct clause after select eliminate the duplicate rows for the result set. See here, this is a repeated value is not here, and distinct all you can also, all will display all the values. See A1, A1 repeated two times. If I am making here distinct, A1 will be display once, A2 will be display once. And what does describe the structure of table which you have already created. Existing table structure can be viewed by using describe table name. To view structure of table, not a table. To view all the databases from your system, show databases, all the databases will be displayed. To view all the tables from that database, show tables can be used. So this can be creating a user from local. So here, see how to use grant all privilege, that is your connectivity topics. So we'll discuss later on that. So grant all on, just you have to write this word, grant all on star dot star mean all. This means all to particular table, host name, any user ID, password with the grant option. So any you can give the range with the between can also view the range of the value between, not between, value between. See, I am displaying roll number between 10 to 20. So what I'll write, select star from student where roll number between 10 and 20, and not 2 will be not used here. And not between means which I have mentioned over there, that will not display, other will be display. So in is another keywords, that will display, which I have mentioned here, only that value will be display, other will not display. See here, select star from student where roll number in. Where roll number in means which I have mentioned, just like a membership operator, 1001, 1002, 310. Only these record will be display, other will not display. If I am applying before in not, so these record will not display, other will be display. So this is a very important topic of like to display the pattern in your records, in your table, from your tables. Any pattern, any alphabetically records can be viewed. Any condition you can apply with the like clause. There are two types of wildcard characters can be used in a with the like. That is, one is a modular operator, percentage, another is a underscore. So check even a character string against the pattern by default like operator. These are a case sensitive ones, which you have written in a which case, capital, small, that likes with the like and not like you can also use. See here, percentage and underscore can be used for that pattern man. See the example here. Select star from student table name where username like ADM percentage. Beginning with the ADM, other characters can be any. This percentage specify the last character can be any beginning with the ADM. And here, middle of the ADM, beginning can be any, ending can be any. So here, this is specify the number of underscore for each characters. It will select all the record from where name, username like one underscore A. So second letter as A, other characters can be any. If I am mentioning here M, ADM, so what does it? It will search for a ADM. Beginning can be any. So second character A or M, other can be N. So not and not null is also, null means empty. Not null means which is not a empty, that can be also. For this, to view this, is null or is not null can be used. Is operator can be used with the this. So there is a join also. Yesterday we have discussed about it. Join. There are so many joins here. Join means to view records from a more than one table. Cross join, inner join, equi join, natural join, left and right join also. So cross join means all the columns with the star will be displayed, and it is called cross join or Cartesian product. Cartesian join. See the example of this. All the record from a first table and all the record from a second table will be displayed. So what is the command for this? Select star from first table. Cross join teacher. First table student comma teacher, you can also write there. It will view all the record from a first table, cross join second table. So this is a inner join. So inner part can be joined. See the example of this. Select member. This is a table name. Dot, from this table I am retrieving this first name and last name. Second table, this is a movie title from a first table and second table. So where movie.id equal members.movie.id. Both first table ID or second table ID should be matched. Here this is a wrong, this is a member. Both are correct. Movies and members should be matching. So equijoin in this. So equijoin equality can be checked. So outer join, left join, right side join, we have discussed yesterday. So there is a comment in also in a MySQL, SQL. So with the slash operator, one is a hash operator with the single line comments, and multi line comments can be used with the forward slash followed by the asterisk and in a ending star followed by the forward slash. So that is called single line or multi line comments can be used in a MySQL or SQL. So thank you. Hope you have understand all the topics and revise at home and practice also. Thank you.